Innovation's a bit of a recurring theme in this episode, and in this next story, we visit an old friend.
There's not much in GRDC's portfolio of research projects to equal the Harrington Seed Destructor, or so you might think. Invented by Ray Harrington, the HSD has been, over the last 4 years, studied, trialled and modified by research engineers at the University of South Australia. And while that research has been underway, so has a parallel project, which could see a new version of the technology available in 5 to 10 years. Packed in behind the covers on the rear of this harvester is an integrated weed destructor. It's like a Harrington seed destructor in that it pounds the life out of weed seeds, but the resemblance stops there. Leading the university research team is Dr. Chris Saunders.
We compared impact theory with the data we collected from the HSD. We then did some lab testing, we did some computer simulation, and we got very good relationships between the speed of the cage mill, the size, the design, and why it was killing those weed seeds. And from that, we were able to redesign and optimize a method of providing the critical impact speeds to a weed seed in a chaff fraction to kill it.
The integrated device will require a complete reconfiguration of the HSD technology. In this early prototype, changes include the replacement of the cage mill with its separate motor and the trailer needed to carry it. Instead, there are now twin mills driven by the harvester, fed by a split stream of material from the back of the sieve. The milled residue exits either side of the device for a better distribution across the paddock.
We needed to have a machine that was going to cope with a much larger volume of chaff coming through it. So a Class 9 harvester producing almost double what the other harvesters in the past have been doing. We knew that we needed a much bigger unit.
Only larger capacity harvesters would have enough power to allow the integrated device to run off the internal supply with minimal effect on the header's performance.
It's the evolution of the HSD. It's where I always want it to be, in the header. And I could say thanks to GRDC and Farmers Money.
Financial support that amounted to $1.5 million, not including monies Ray Harrington initially put into the HSD. Initial tests have produced positive results. However, this integrated prototype will require further development and testing to evaluate how well it performs at various speeds and under different loads.
From our lab testing, we know that the proportion of kill increases with the proportion of rotational speed, and there's a characteristic that's specific to our machines, and there's a characteristic that's specific to the Harrington cage mill. So what we're doing is varying those rotational speeds and also varying the throughput of material, and then monitoring the speed of the mills and the power of the mills for each of those settings to get the curves and the characteristics of our system.
Sifting through what's left of the chaff and seed that's gone through the new mills, Ray Harrington reckons it's pretty good gear.
This is doing as good a job, this new style of mill is doing as good a job or better job than the original.
A good understanding of air and grain flows through the back end of the harvester enabled the university's engineers to design virtual models even before taking the project into the workshop. And being able to install the device underneath the back end provided the flexibility to have it fold away when not needed and to be retrofitted to suitable harvesters. Extensive work will have to be done with harvester manufacturers around warranty-related issues, and the research engineers want to do more before they finish this project.
If we can increase the number of weed seeds in that chaff fraction by improving the way the harvester separates that chaff and also get more seeds into the front of the harvester, we can potentially then kill more weed seeds in this operation, so therefore increasing the efficacy of the integrated system.
This prototype doesn't mean that the trail behind HSD will be quietly retired to the shed. Older harvesters don't have the horsepower to drive an integrated destructor. And because there's more engineering to be done and manufacturers have a long lead time for changes to production schedules, it could be another 10 years before a retrofit version is commercially available. GRDC foresees a need for the existing HSD for a long time yet. And in 2012, licensed the manufacture of the Trail Behind Destructor to South Australian firm De Bruin Engineering, which has contributed to the refinement seen in the latest version.
We need a complete package to manage resistant weeds or herbicide resistant weeds, and having something like the Harrington Seed Destructor during harvest is another string to the bow to help us tackle these problems.
The technology that's been created, as well as the technology currently under development, is world class, according to GRDC's Farm Technologies Manager, Paul Maybush.
Look, all these types of inventions have many fathers, and this one is no exception. There's been a lot of people involved. Ray Harrington is still involved and has offered a lot of good advice as we've been moving through the research phase. But I have to put a special mention to Nick Berry, the young PhD student that started his scholarship, a GRDC scholarship on this project. He was integral in doing some of the very basic work of understanding what kills weed seeds. So understanding the amount of impact and the number of impacts that you're actually required to kill a seed.
Fathered by many and supported by GRDC, this innovative engineering prototype promises to deliver more options and more great results for grain growers.